Hey CG, I'm Reagan.
And I'm Madison.
And this is your weekly broadcast for the week of September 28th. Samantha Gutierrez gives us the update on CG's National Merit Finalists.
Their recognition is based upon their junior year PSAT scores. Eight of our students recognized with this. There are around 16,000 National Merit semifinalists that are being recognized this year. I think there's around about 350 or so in Indiana that are being honored from about 100 different schools in the state of Indiana. So it's great to know that Center Grove High School is one of those high schools with eight of those 350 or so students that have reached that semifinalist status. These students are outstanding students. They have taken a number of challenging and rigorous courses throughout their high school career. Looking at their transcripts, they have taken many honors and advanced placement courses, really challenging them throughout their high school career. And I think that has really prepared them well to succeed and do well on the PSAT test. And again,
All eight of us at the school this year, I think, are going to try for that. The application process has an essay. It's based on your actual SAT scores, not just the PSAT. Your extracurriculars, information that the school gives about the students' classes, that sort of thing.
We will know in early 2013, probably around February or March, whether eight semifinalists become actual finalists. And I think we have a pretty good possibility that most, if not all of them, would be finalists. So we will wait and see. But congratulations to all of them.
Thanks, Samantha. As always, some of the staircases are still crowded. Dustin Grissom shows us some alternate routes to get to class on time.
What can you do to dodge the traffic of that main staircase that made former CG student and tweeter Joe Dan the Man quote, "I don't even go to CG anymore. I moved to North Carolina, and I still get slowed down by the main staircase's traffic out here." Or how about Troy Smith, respected class president, in his claim, "It's like JCPenney's on Black Friday, only every day of the year." Later, passionately adding, wait. Also put, "And there's no deal, so it's just bad overall." I probably was intending to put in one cohesive quote. But anyways, how about the horrible uncomfortableness student Shelby Hawk has experienced? Sassily quoting, "People are just getting in my bubble." Without proper physical prowess, it can almost be impossible to get through the staircase alive. As Sam Elliott proudly proclaims, "The largest on the staircase will always prosper." So, if you lack the physical strength and mental toughness to make it through the hallway and up the staircase alive, what can you do? Well, you can take a different route, such as the staircase in the band hallway, the staircase at the opposite end of the stairway of death, down the social studies hallway, or how about the lovely staircases at the end of the CGTV hallway that goes up to the English wing, or, my personal favorite, the one tucked in the corner of the bottom floor, or the one that leads from the lunchroom down to the science hallway. There's so many amazing options to avoid death. Choose one. So, in summary,
in the light of College Go Week, here is a brief informational video on some advantages of college.
Having a college degree versus a high school diploma means a richer life in all respects.
I will buy a home.
Take care of my family.
Travel the world.
Inspire my children to achieve more.
I will have the energy to enjoy my life.
Stand on my own 2 feet.
Bring people together.
I will make change happen.
Here are five of the ways a college education pays.
You'll earn an average of $22,000 more per year than a high school graduate.
And an average of 63% more in hourly wages.
Graduating college also gives you a degree more security and a little less worry. You're less than half as likely to be unemployed.
And much more likely to be covered by an employer's health insurance.
As a college grad, you're less likely to be obese.
Plus, you'll exercise more vigorously, more often.
A college degree matters to the next generation, too. If you have kids, you'll read to them more.
You'll also be much more likely to take them to a live show or concert.
Finally, college helps you define your role in your community and your world, and how you can contribute. Did you know college grads between 18 and 24 were much more likely than high school grads to vote in the last election?
Or that they're twice as likely to volunteer for a good cause?
Greater wealth.
More security.
Better health.
Closer family.
Stronger community.
Five ways ed pays.
And to wrap up our broadcast, Hannah Sturm gives us a recap of homecoming week.
Homecoming week is number one! What do you know once you show up to the homecoming dance?
Baby, what you gotta say? All you're giving me is fiction. I'm a sorry sucker and this happens all the time. Everybody talks.
It started with, how did you love me? We could be starving, we could be homeless, we could be broke.
We could be broke.
all we have for you today, CG. Bye.
Bye.